Listen.
Welcome along to the Newcastle Entertainment Centre. I'm Terry Allen, glad to have you company for the Mitsubishi Challenge in 1994. Tonight we're coming to you from the Newcastle Entertainment Centre, where we see the fourth game of the season for the Newcastle Falcons. And boy, they really have had an unexpected turnabout this season. They finished fifth last year, and many people thought they'd go on to bigger and better things, including myself. But tonight, their opponents, Geelong Supercats, the Falcons, they've lost 3 out of 3, and they've been dead unlucky, I can tell you. And the Geelong Supercats, having taken the wooden spoon, are now right up there in about 8th position, so they really are playing well. And it should be a cracker of a game. They've already met once this year, and like I said, it's only the fourth game of the year for the Falcons, but the Geelong Supercats have already beaten them once. And more about their lineups in just a minute. Back in the hot seat again, Greg Hendricks, how do you see this one going?
I'm really looking forward to the game because I like to see teams play under pressure, and Newcastle sure are under pressure tonight. It's not that they've played badly, certainly they could have easily have beaten the Adelaide Sixers and Melbourne, so their form is not that bad. They just haven't been able to finish off, and of course they'll be out for revenge because Geelong did beat them. A very important win for Geelong. They've won a couple, so they do know how to get across the line. I think it'll be interesting, and Everett Stevens is a man to be shut down, and I think the Falcons might be able to do it. I think they'll bounce back tonight after a couple of weeks off.
Well, Everett Stevens probably the key to it to the Newcastle Falcons as we go to the starting fives, just to have a look at those. We see for the Falcons the pocket rocket Derek Rucker, also number 5 in coming on tonight, starting the game. Michael Johnson. We have Grant Kruger in number 11. Terry Dozier, the captain in 35, and 00 in the centre, Paul Kuiper. Now here we go. Everett Stevens with the Falcons last year. He's left. He's gone to the Supercats, and he's really come out firing. We have Vince Hinchin there, Cecil Exum, Adrian Branch, and Ray Borner, the Boomer.
Well, I think the benches here tonight, particularly Newcastle, are going to have a fair bit to do with this game. Tony Jensen, he's a live wire in singlet number 9. Sean Dennis won't play a lot. Marty McLean, he can really get up and down the court. Alexander, a big man, and so too is Simpson. They'll all need to come out and really do a big defensive job. Justin Cass is a very tidy player. Nice outside shooter. Jason Joins, another ex-Newcastle lad, returning here tonight. There's Lenarden, Curl, and Isles. That's the lineup for the Supercats. I think the Falcons might just have it on the bench.
And as the national anthem concludes here at the Newcastle Entertainment Centre, a very good evening to you. The referees for tonight, John Payne, Roger Shields, Kevin Marsh, and a capacity crowd, Greg, in for what should be a tremendous game. Falcons, Geelong Supercats.
Very knowledgeable sporting crowds, aren't they, in Newcastle? And they know even this early in the season, it's a game that the Falcons simply must win because they've got many tougher opponents than this to come along. I'm not sledging the Geelong Supercats, but I think most people around the league would concede they're not going to be there come playoff time. But everyone expects, I think, that the Falcons will. And now's the time they've really got to get after it. It's interesting too, isn't it, Terry, that they've had a couple of weeks off. A total of 2 weeks off. They had the bye last week. And I know the guys went out and had a game of golf. And they're hoping that might help turn things around. And I can tell you that team manager Dennis Kibble is certainly hoping that's the case, because he'd like to go out instead of going to training playing golf every week. So he'll be hoping that they do have a big game coming off a round of golf during the week.
Well, I certainly hope they find the hole tonight better than Dennis Kibble's putter. Look at that, the jumper from Terry Dozier to start. Now that is different, isn't it, from last time we were here at the Newcastle Entertainment Centre against the Adelaide Sixers. The Falcons were 9-0 down in the opening couple of minutes, and immediately one shot out of one shot. So that's a tremendous start for the Falcons. But just getting back to what you were saying about Geelong not really being figured in finals, there is a real evening up amongst all teams this year. You just cannot pick which teams are going to be there and which are not. It's so close.
Now, they've certainly got some talent out there, haven't they? The Australian centre in Ray Borner, the ex-NBA star, number 24, Adrian Branch from the LA Lakers, and, of course, Everett Stevens, who's also had some NBA experience, and he was with the Falcons for a couple of years there and did a mighty job for them. They went looking for Derek Rucker, so the clash between those two is going to be a real classic as they put up the shot, but it doesn't go down.
And here he comes, the man himself, Derek Rucker, MVP with the Brisbane Bullets in 1990. Terry Dozier tries it again, and it's in! Well, Derek Rucker and Everett Stevens, this is a tremendous, tremendous matchup. A lot of people were wondering, oh, what a great tap in there from Ray Borner. Just grabs it and slots it back in again. Plenty of experience there from the big boomer. 15 for the Geelong Supercats. Now, these two, a lot of people were saying, is Derek as good as Everett? How did they match up? And really seeing them on the court together should answer that question for us tonight.
Pretty interesting defense too from Ray Borner. As we see him make three from three, that's Paul Kleiber getting into the act. And there's plenty of defensive pressure out here. They've obviously been working on that. They go up the Falcons, but it's broken pretty comfortably. And Ray Borner shoots one, comes up short over the back, and they're after it now through Derek Rucker.
Well, if the Falcons press releases are to be believed, they've had some pretty heavy workouts. Some heavy D, and it couldn't stop Grant Kruger going to the bucket. There he is, the man. He's shaved and he's ready. And again, the assist from Derek Rucker, who really is right up there in the NBL with assists.
That's a blistering start from the Falcons. 4 from 4, and they really go in and make it very, very tough there.
And there he is. Cecil Exum has been fouled. And the man who scored.
Let's get a shot. We're right on it. Cameraman's doing a good job. So is our director. He's hurt, and knee trouble is the worst kind of trouble. As we see the replay there, Grant Kruger going in, and he's come down hard on his knee. He is in a lot of trouble sideline, and in fact the coach of the Geelong Supercats, Jim Calvin, is over there helping him out, and it looks as though he may have, he's done some serious damage there.
I think
looks actually as though some sort
cut.
Of dislocation. He's in a lot of pain as he goes by us now, and he's also received a cut to the knee, but I don't think it's the external problem that's concerning the Falcons bench as he comes down with the assistance of some of the handlers here.
Well, that is a tremendous blow for the Newcastle Falcons. I mean, especially a player who, on the starting five, has done some serious damage. There will be stitches. And we just hope that there's nothing snapped in the knee as well.
Couldn't make either of those shots, Cecil Exum, so he'll be disappointed, but not half as Grant Kruger. And we actually saw Grant Kruger, the bench, the Newcastle bench is right next to our commentary position. He looked down at his knee and he could see that it was disfigured. He's in a lot of trouble as Derek Rucker makes an amazing assist.
Five
from five, the Falcons. They have shot at 100% and they are out 10-2. And this is entirely new Falcons we're seeing here right now after the two-week layoff. Let's look at that assist from Derek Rucker. Well, he's leading the league. He has 12 per game and that was a classic.
It certainly was. Derek Rucker is one of the most tremendous dynamic players in the league. But it's not just for his scoring ability, although goodness knows he can score plenty of points. He makes the others play well as well.
Cecil Exum doing a job inside there. He's a good inside-outside man. Went hard to the basket to make it 10-4. Newcastle leading the way early. Mike Johnson, can he keep that 100% record going? He can. They haven't missed a shot, the Falcons. 6 from 6.
That's absolutely tremendous. The Newcastle Falcons shooting 44 from the field, and Geelong way down tonight. That percentage is just way down. Derek Rucker goes right to the bucket.
They make it 7 from 7. It's miracle stuff. And they go hard to the basket, and Jim Calvin, the Geelong coach, says, let's talk this over. We need some D out here, guys. They're walking around us as we see Derek Rucker. He just strolls to the basket. Magnificent stuff. And it's 14-4, Newcastle over Geelong.
8:45 left in the first quarter. And Tom Wiseman must be very happy with his charges at the moment. Plenty of work to go. Plenty of time left in the game too. 14-4, the Falcons.
Well, let's see whether we can join Tom Wiseman in the huddle. He's being found out there. When we get that, we'll just reflect on for a moment on that dreadful injury in the second minute of the game to Grant Kruger, one of the real young guns of the league. He's out now. I don't think we're going to see him for some weeks. Just a feeling you get when you see an injury like that. He looked down. He was distressed. We could actually see physically that he was in a lot of trouble when we had a look at that knee. So we'll try and get a report at quarter time for you. But that's going to hurt them in this game because they've got guys like Ray Borner who will go hard to the basket. They need his muscle out there. But it's a chance for the like now Simpson. Kuiper always stands up. And the other big man in Matty Alexander to get out there and do the job.
14-4 is the score. 8:45 left in the first quarter. And boy, it's certainly been an amazing start from the Falcons. Have not missed a shot. 100% shooting 44 from the field this year. Supercats shooting 46. And although I should say that a couple of Falcons that are actually shooting 100% from the foul shot line, Tony Jensen and Terry Dozier, two that haven't missed all year from the line. Boy, I no idea they could do it from the field as well. What do you know? We can only pray, though, that Grant Kruger's knee is only a flesh wound. I could say, though, although I'm not an expert in this department at all, that it didn't look as bad as, say, Paul Kuiper's a couple of years ago. There was no kneecap hanging out or anything. So we trust it. He'll be back on the court very soon. No one likes to see those turnovers. Derek Rucker again goes all the way to the bucket, and it's in.
8 from 8.
Well, I wonder what the statistics will show about the Falcons' percentages and the best start to a game ever. I can't recall them going 8 from 8 before.
I can't recall anyone going 8 from 8 before. They go inside this time and they get crunched. Caesar Lexham complains, but he gets no joy from the referee. And let's have a look now. We've gone into the dressing sheds now. In there with the handlers. Ice goes straight onto the knee. See that cut there?
Yeah, well, the knee obviously it looks to be intact, but I don't know whether any ligaments have been damaged underneath there.
That cut's much worse than we thought. There's another one for Paul Kuiper as we watch the game.
We'll keep you up to date, definitely, with the injury to Grant Kruger and get back to you soon. In the meantime, there's some fouling, number 20 for the Falcons, and that'll be on Matthew Alexander, who's coming to replace Grant Kruger. It's 18-4, just under 8 minutes left in the quarter now, and the Geelong Supercats really have to start doing something. Everett Stevens, perhaps he's the man to do it. We couldn't make that one. Paul Kuiper almost not knowing what to do with the ball. For a minute there, he thought he was going to have to dribble it way back into enemy territory. Derek Rucker now.
That'll be
privilege.
No problem for Paul, Terry. He's a great ball handler. There's no doubt about that. He'd love it. Bit of between the legs stuff around the back. But
and the long one. That's an air ball. There you go. Well, now it's 8 from 9. So the 100% record has been tarnished just a little bit, but wasn't it so tremendous? Cecil Exum fakes. No, tremendous D.
There's some defense in there, all right. It's traffic and it's heavy. So Matt Alexander in singlet number 20 is out there now, the big fellow. And he's got a real job to do in replacing. Oh, and he just stands his ground and forces the travel. And again, the Supercats, they complain and complain bitterly. But again, Cecil, the violation, and they come away with it, the Falcons. So Alexander on that occasion did supremely.
Fairly quiet start from Adrian Branch, I thought, at this stage. How did you see him playing so far? Just finding his feet?
Haven't sighted him yet. He's taken a couple of outside shots, which haven't dropped. Derek Rucker, though, goes straight by him and gets it inside. Kuiper over the top, and Derek Rucker, the assist king of the NBL. He's wearing the crown supremely.
Top scorer, too, for the Falcons, averaging 27 a game. Terry Dozier is averaging 24. And there they are, just getting a bit of anaesthetic into that cut so they can stitch it up. This is not good television at all, my goodness.
It's pretty nasty.
I hope you've had your dinner before your supper before you tune in.
Well, that is Grant Kruger, who was injured early up as Adrian Branch misses that shot. But hopefully that is all the injury is, superficial. I mean, it's pretty deep and pretty nasty, but it's a sort of thing that you'd imagine he might recover from within a couple of weeks. You'd at least hope so, but we'll get more on that at quarter time.
He certainly doesn't look to be a happy boy here. He's in a fair bit of pain. It's not good at all. And Adrian Branch cannot take it from the line. And it's still 20-4, the Falcons. Mike Johnson! And that's a three-pointer. The Newcastle Falcons can hardly do anything wrong. Vince Hinchin, Everett Stevens. Cecil Exum off to Ray Borner. Takes the two. And it's not dropping for the Supercats tonight. Derek Rucker. Terry Dozier comes inside. The assist to Kuiper. There's a travel.
Well,
an amazed look on Paul Kuiper's face. And Roger Shields getting an earful from Tom Wiseman as well for an explanation. And there's a timeout there. They go into the huddle and it's 23-4 Newcastle Falcons. A great start over the Geelong Supercats. 6 minutes left in the quarter. Let's hear what Jim Calvin has to say, if we can, in the huddle to see what he's going to do to get back into this game.
Jumpers, no charges, crowds into it now. We've still got three timeouts left. They get six in a row, we'll take them now and then. Just calm the thing down. You're going to be all right. Keep taking the shot.
And there it is, Jim Calvin in the huddle. It's a timeout. And at the moment, with 6 minutes left, the Falcons 23, Supercats 4.
The Newcastle Entertainment Centre, there it is, a packed house, and are they enjoying themselves here tonight in Newcastle? 23-4, the locals lead, the Geelong Supercats, and some more good news. I'm a bit of a mug. I thought that was a fairly serious injury, but I'm told from the message from Dr. Andrew McDonald, the Falcons doctor here, is that it doesn't appear to be internal. It is that very, very nasty cut, which obviously is going to keep him out for some time, but there's no serious internal damage. So there is good news, that's that. But it did look pretty nasty, and there's Ray Borner going hard to the hoop to make it 23-6. And we're just 6 minutes into the game, so they're scoring at breakneck pace, the Falcons.
Well, that certainly is good news. No one on any team likes to see an injury, no matter how minimal or serious, to any player. And that's it's been a blow to the Falcons tonight. Let's hope they can recover for their sake, and that indeed Grant Kruger won't be long out of the game. 25-6. Great shot, Paul Piper. Ray Borner away now. He finds Cecil Exum, Adrian Branch. Some big, strong defence there from the big centre, double zero, Paul Piper. Derek Rucker comes back with it now. So the turnover, the shot was sort of a shot anyway. They couldn't quite get to the bucket.
And Derek Rucker, the point guard, looks like he's on a mission. He's thrown a couple of great assists, and he's really giving it to Everett Stevens here tonight. So the points go early to Derek Rucker, and the rebound goes to Matt Alexander. Here's Rucker again. Let's see what he can do. He holds it up. They've got a fresh 30-second clock, and they'll run their stuff.
Terry Dozier now. He stands for the jump shot, and it's in. That's worth two. Terry Dozier just asking for the foul on the arm. It was a big no call from the referees. Ray Borner now.
I thought he might have been just feeling that arm there because it's white hot.
You're not wrong. Fouls. And the Newcastle Falcons, pretty strong defense tonight. So one of the things they've really been working on, and there it is, a bit of a shove in the back from double zero, Paul Kuiper. 27-6. Tremendous start. I mean, we might have to go to the record book here to see what sort of scores the Falcons have kept their opponents to in the first quarter. This is an all-time low one, Supercats. And it's in. Cecil Exum managing to get some points back there.
Cecil Exum again at the line trying to bridge this. It's turning out to be a pretty huge gap. Well, he's got it back from 20 to just 19. We've only played 8 minutes. It's been some sort of start. So they go up and try a little pressure D now. So Vince Hinch can go up there and take them on. He's down with Alexander. Just the one substitution made so far by the Falcons, a fourth substitution. Grant Kruger out of this game with an injured knee. They get it off the boards quickly. Terry Dozier's missed one. Into Borner, he ought to score from there, he will. Turns around, left hand, spin underneath, and very clever play from number 15 for Geelong, Australian centre.
Well, I can tell you that the least points by a team against the Falcons scored in a quarter was in 1987, and that was Illawarra. It was 10 points in a quarter. And Geelong Supercats now have 10 points. So, they still have 3.5 minutes left to beat that. Rather dubious record, but it's pretty messy stuff under the basket. Eddie Alexander goes to the line. Tony Jensen's on, former Townsville Suns sharpshooter.
And he's the sort of guy who'll really enjoy this game. They're getting up and down quickly. There's a lot of scoring going on, particularly from the gentleman in the white singlets, and Alexander really stood up there, made a tough basket, and then really made them pay for the foul on the shot. Takes it out by 20 points. We're just 9 minutes into the game. Here's Branch now, goes for the drive. He's great on that running jumper there. And makes good. So Derek Rucker just waits for his buddy to come on down. Number 20 getting across the picture there and into the offense. Alexander doing up his shoelace. Here's Tony Jensen now with Vince Hinchin, the job on him. Alexander takes up a lot of space, sets a good screen there. They work around now. Let's watch for some magic from Rucker. Great ball. And the push goes against, I think, Paul Kuiper. Let's just check it with the referee, John Payne. It is double zero, so he's tacking a few up here. He has two fouls early and takes a break now. Marty McLean comes in. So a real running five out there now for the Falcons, a real speed machine. Tony Jensen, Derek Rucker and Marty McLean. Watch these guys fly, backed up by Terry Dozier and Matt Alexander. Let's see what the Supercats can do. They've been rattled by this blazing start. It was a good drive there by Vince Hinchin.
Yes, he's called that on Marty McLean, but it was way before the shot. So it'll be a side ball, I would think. No, it's not, is it? Oh, it's one-on-one, of course.
Backed up a few fouls with a physical style of play. Kruger has two, but of course, if you've just joined us, he's out of the game with an injured knee. Has a very nasty cut across the top. And Paul Kuiper sits with two. Alexander's done well since he's come into the game. 30 points to 13, 3 minutes out from quarter time.
And there's only 2:45 left in the quarter. Marnie McLean now on to Terry Dozier. Derek Rucker, who's played the most minutes of all in the NBL. He rarely sits down on the bench, this guy. And they're hot tonight. 32-13. What a start.
He is something. He just uses his body movement to drag them away from the other man in the lane.
Tony Jensen. Feel.
Here we go. Terry Dozier. Oh, I think a little crunk, but they raced across there and just managed to stop it. Vince Hinchin.
It's too big. Ray Borner really clinging that one. I tell you what, I think Justin Cass was lucky to get a hand to it. It was a tall pass, that one. 34-13, 2 minutes 10 left in the quarter. Derek Rucker bringing it back. He'll be enjoying this. He's having a tremendous night. Marty McLean enjoying the scrap as well. Tony Jensen goes left. And at this turnover by Everett Stevens, he dunks it. And he's an opposition player, but a fairly warm reception from the dunking king. There it is. The crowd's seen him do it so often in Falcons colours. Ironically, last year, one of the things Everett Stevens wanted to cut down out of his game was turnovers. This year, he's done that, and he's picking up some steals.
Well, it's an all-new Falcons. The bench here, as we just see Matt Alexander go hard, and they almost tackle him there. Not much doubt about that foul. He'll get a couple of shots. But the Falcons bench has been up on its feet. There they are. They're sitting down and relaxing now in this short break in play. And Tom Wiseman is stalking the line. And it's been such a good start that any mistake is sending Tom's blood pressure through the roof. And we saw, of course, an error there. The turnover from Marty McLean. And boy, if looks could kill Marty, he'd be dead. But it's about the only mistake the Falcons have made in the first quarter. And it's 35-15. They still hold it by 20.
Well, this is a fairly big margin to be taking into quarter time. 1:30, 90 seconds left in the quarter. 35-15. The Falcons are up by 20. Any team would like to have a 20-point buffer going into quarter time. Everett with the assist.
Justin Cass was a great shot from outside, and they needed that. They've got a speedy three out there too with Justin Cass, Simon Curl and Everett Stevens to match the three-guard rotation of the Falcons. So it's a good battle. Some real quicks out there. Terry Dozier, will he beat them outside? Goes hard. Exum's in there, and through comes Matt Alexander, who really is letting everyone know he's out there tonight. Been very impressed.
Well, he has to fill the shoes of Grant Kruger, and he's got to do some tough stuff if he's going to do that. It's a physical game tonight. 35-17.
young journeyman here, Simon Curl. And Simon, congratulations, 100 games tonight, and I'm sure that'll be watching up there in Brisbane. He'll be pretty proud. Young man's done well in the league. Cody Jensen looks in, switches hands, lays it in left. So they really get out and run. That's the way they like to play it.
Plenty of commitment from the Falcons bench tonight. And on court, they're running into attack and they're running back to defence. Curl.
Makes a nice cut. I was watching him then. He did well.
Strong D, and that'll be on Tommy Jensen.
They didn't react to a rotate, but they did help. And there's the foul.
And Simon Curl will go to the line.
Pretty good defense there from Tony Jensen to get over and help out there after the Falcons were beaten at the top, 37-17. And we're 20 seconds out from quarter time after just an amazing start from the Falcons. The 2 weeks off has done them no harm. And that's good news for Dennis Kibble, because a couple of days on the golf course has really worked wonders. They might go back. That will please the manager. Simon Curl makes that one, 37-18. Can't make the second. And Derek Rucker will bring it away for just one shot, and they'll see whether they can't go in 21 points ahead if they can make two here.
Derek Rucker now. Man on a mission. Everett Stevens shadows him. He gets around him, but
so what?
Big D. Everett Stevens back. And the assist for Vince Hinchin, couldn't make it. And that's it. Quarter time. How do you like that? What a start from the Falcons. That's tremendous. Good to see Grant Kruger back off the bench with that knee bandaged up, but he's okay. He probably won't take any further part tonight, but he's back on the bench, and that's good news for all concerned. So there it is at quarter time at the Newcastle Entertainment Centre. The Falcons 37, Geelong Supercats 18.